today to thank the boldness of our government and our shareholders.
William Hamilton built his venture on the ashes of the Second World War. Copper mine he envisioned was ransacking the First Nation's ancestral territories, drawing the wrath of the local people. It definitely took nerves of steel to stay the course, despite all this hostility. Before long, in the face of William Hamilton's cold and uncompromising stance, the petitions and peaceful protests turned into sabotage, vandalism, and other criminal acts. The industrialists' private properties also encountered the wrath of the demonstrations. Carl Faubert, a veteran of the Korean War, was hired from Montreal as a private detective to shed some light on this whole thing. But at the end of his long journey to northern Quebec, the detective did not only encounter property damage, he also came face to face with the corpse of William Hamilton. The strangeness only kept building throughout the investigation. A powerful, unseasonable blizzard hit the region. Bodies frozen in unbreakable ice appeared. The local fauna began to act strangely and aggressively. Carl Faubert began to doubt his own sanity. The detective felt the weight of a gaze, as if he were at the mercy of a powerful, feral creature waiting for the right moment to attack. Carl's fear was taking over, overpowering his reason. He was giving in to delirium. In that instant, he thought that the dark waters of the lake might shield him from the shapes that pursued him. From there, he had a renewed hope in civilization, or whatever was left of it. Carl knew that on one of these shores stood William Hamilton's lavish mansion, and there the detective had hopes of finding a way out of the area. A phone, a truck, who knows? Under the luxurious paneling and damask carpets, he might be able to find answers to his questions. Detective wondered about the floating debris. Had it drifted out from the shore, or had it been abandoned there in the middle of nowhere? Carl saw a boat in the distance, clearly. Had he finally made it to civilization? Were he at by gunshots? Time to flee again, and fast. Charles swam without. He was desperate. The icy water and his wounds made him feel weaker and weaker. He had to get to shore. Bleeding and the hypothermia were tearing at Carl's poor body. When he finally saw a light in the distance, he was filled with a faint sense of hope. Was convinced that he would not wake up if he went to sleep in this state. It was probably best to make a fire and take a look at his wounds. Carl struggled to wake up. His makeshift bandages offered him little time. If he wanted to find the truth, he had to get to Hamilton Manor without delay. There was something the detective found charming about the mechanism of the instant cameras. Carl left his refuge, knowing that he was headed to a more comfortable, but otherwise ominous place, Hamilton's mansion. He knew that wolves do not attack people. Still, he had to be careful. Wolves do not generally attack human beings. At least, not unless you attack them first. Tried to put the horror into perspective. Accidents happen, and in the inhospitable far north, it happens more often than not. Nevertheless, a feeling of deja vu stayed with him, as if the carnage was not over. What were these mysterious fragments, and why was there a warning about the broom? This letter raised more questions than it answered for the detective. Thank you. Black crowberry has long been a part of the diet of the Innu of Quebec, who consume it to protect themselves from the cold. This was the mansion of the late William Hamilton. No doubt about it. There was no other rich industrialist in the area to have a sumptuous mansion built in the middle of nowhere. This letter, found in the cabin, mentioned a gazebo. The key to the mansion would likely be there. Carl was overcome with a strange emotion. The crossword puzzle was in French, so he guessed it was the work of a Hamilton employee and not Hamilton himself. Carl was overcome with a strange emotion. The crossword puzzle was in French, so he guessed it was the work of a Hamilton employee and not Hamilton himself. From a simple case of vandalism to a mysterious murder, Carl found himself right in the middle of a battlefield. What could possibly await him now?